are. What do you think? I know it's not much, but it's got a good foundation. If I do a little work to it...
It's perfect. It's exactly how I pictured it.
Go ahead, look around. I'll bring Sam in.
I love it, Frank. It's perfect.
I think Sam likes it. Fit for a king, I think.
Yeah, it is. It's too much.
No, not at all. I wish I could have done more to the house, but with you and Sam, the book, I just...
It's beautiful. Thank you.
Hold still a sec.
What's this for?
It's just a thank you for being so understanding.
You don't have to get me anything. I support you no matter what.
And it's also for being a mom.
I know I haven't been very supportive of this move, but I know in my heart it's best for all of us. I think I'm gonna try and get some sleep.
Did I get you anything?
No, I think I just need some rest.
All right, I'm gonna wash up here and unload a few more things still. Pretty tired.
Okay, good night.
Sleep well.
Shouldn't you be writing?
Yes, but I need to get the house somewhat livable. We came here for a better life. I want the house to reflect that.
I know, but you're gonna need to get something on paper.
Please, don't start with me.
Who's starting with you? I just want what's best for you.
Well, then what's best for me is to get the house ready to live in.
Okay. So can you promise me that you're gonna write something soon?
I will, I promise. You wanna go?
I don't think I'm ready.
Sure you are. You've always been ready.
I thought we agreed you weren't gonna push me.
You're right. I just thought that...
Yeah, well, you thought wrong.
Hey, I got an idea. Why don't we go outside for a walk in the woods? Bring Sam with us. The sun's about to set. It'll be beautiful.
Oh, that sounds wonderful. I'm really tired. I think I'm just gonna rest, okay?
Well, I'm gonna go for a walk.
Anyone there? Hello? I'm Frank Brooksfield. I just moved in next door and I thought I would come by. Looks like there's a storm coming. We could be in for some rough.
What do you want?
Yeah, well, like I said, I just moved in next door, and I just wanted to come by.
Go away.
Look, I'm sorry if I scared you. I didn't.
My husband's in the house, you know.
Yeah. Well, I knocked. Nobody answered the door.
Did you hear me?
Okay. Okay. Look, I'm sorry if I frighten you. I
said, get out of here.
Okay.
Okay.
Julie?
He wasn't breathing, Frank. I swear he wasn't breathing.
It's okay now.
No, it's my fault. I couldn't pick him up. I couldn't touch him. I couldn't check to see if
Julie, it's okay. He's fine now.
No, you don't understand. I almost destroyed our family. I only came back because I hadn't touched him yet. Not like a mother should. I didn't want to leave without having felt that, without having him know my touch.
Julie, everybody's fine. It's all right. What happened?
Oh, Frank, stop it. I can't handle this right now.
What?
You!
What do you mean?
Just can you give me some space, please?
I don't know what you're talking about. What?
Frank,
what
just stop, please. Sorry. I'm so sorry.
Doctor said, when you're ready, it'll happen naturally.
But it's not happening.
It will, Julie. I promise it will. I have to get some flashlights. Are you okay?
Yeah. I just need to sleep.
No.
Go slow, okay? You just need to get used to having him around.
I'm his mother. I shouldn't have to get him.
No shoulds. Sorry, did I wake you?
No.
I put Sam in the nursery. He's out cold. I'm gonna go check and see if the neighbor's phone is working. You'd be okay by yourself for a bit? I'll be as quick as I can.
You all right? Sorry if I startled you again. Is your power out?
No.
So is your phone still working then?
I guess.
Do you think I could use it? The storm blew down the power line to my house. I have no power. Said the storm blew down some pretty big trees. The road to the ferry is blocked. Could be closed for the entire week. Seems I'm out of luck, huh? Does this sort of thing happen often around here?
I suppose.
Well, it seems as though we're stuck out here.
I suppose.
Well, thank you for letting me use your phone. Can I ask a question?
Go on.
How long have you lived out here?
All my life.
Here, on this property. Frank.
Helen.
Well, thank you for letting me move. Boom. Julie?
Frank!
What's the matter?
Can you check on Sam, please?
Sure, why? What's the matter?
He was crying really hard, and I was too afraid to check on him, and then he just all of a sudden he stopped, and he's been quiet ever since.
You still haven't checked him?
I'm sorry.
Yeah, that makes a difference.
What?
You remember when your mom came to visit? We first got the monitor.
She overheard you saying how annoying she was.
I thought she was gonna kill me.
My God, she was mad. What?
It was great to hear you laugh.
Frank, does it have to be so loud?
I'll go downstairs. I can't sleep. was outside. I thought I heard something.
What, like a burglar?
No, not a burglar. I don't know.
What's going on?
Nothing. It was just my imagination.
Why do you have that knife?
Nothing, I just thought I heard something.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I probably just need to get some sleep.
Did you feed?
Yeah, lots.
How long before I started?
Right away.
I think he hates me.
No, he doesn't.
Yes, he does. I'm sure of it.
No, he doesn't. Here.
Jesus, Frank.
I'm sorry, I keep trying to push you and you're not ready.
No, you're right. I'm just afraid.
Don't worry, it'll happen naturally.
Nursery.
What?
Last night when we went to sleep, look.
Thank you. is you? Oh, okay, cleaned up. There we go. There we go.
Hello? Helen? Hello? Hi, how are you? Milk today?
Some. You're gonna make her nervous.
Sorry.
Yeah, well, sorry isn't gonna keep her still.
The reason I came was because I was wondering if you might be able to do some babysitting for us. I could pay you, of course. And I could help out around here. I could chop some wood, milk the goats. I don't think I could do that chicken in a bag thing. Helen. I know that we don't know each other well, but I'm in quite a jam here. My wife, Julie, she's sick. Actually, it's more than that. She has something called postpartum depression. And she's having a very tough time right now. I brought us out here that I could focus on my book. Anyway, it would be a big, big help if you could...
No!
Strange.
What?
Crying?
Sam?
No. Julie. Feel your hands. Oh. You okay?
Thank you.
Maybe he threw up. It could be bile.
That much?
It's bile. It must be. He's sick. He's so pale.
So simple. He's not sick. It's something else.
Frank, when was the last time you slept?
What are you saying? It was me? Yeah, I'm not the one who left him for dead and went running off in the forest in the middle of the night.
I know.
What was so important that you would just up and leave?
I didn't just up and leave. I thought he was dead. My husband was gone. What was I supposed to do?
Julie, you should have waited.
I made a mistake. I know. But that doesn't change what's happening now. I'm his mother. I know what he's feeling, and he's sick. I know he is. You just, please, you just have to trust me. Take him to the hospital.
We can't. And even if we could, how's this gonna look to a doctor? Does this look like a capable parent? What are you gonna tell the doctor? That you mistakenly thought your baby was dead? That you tried to kill yourself? That you couldn't bring yourself to touch him? You still can't. As soon as the roads are clear, we'll take him to the doctor, I promise. But until then, we have to do this together, okay?
Help you.
Get you there. Thank you. Is that your baby?
Yeah. That's Sam.
Oh, I don't like babies.
What is it, Helen?
Leave! Just leave! Stop coming around here!
What are you scared of, Helen? I just want to talk to you.
No!
I think something's trying to hurt Sam.
Helen. Go away, please. Just go away.
Helen, if you know something, I need to know. You know something, don't you?
No. Baby, I don't know. It doesn't make any sense.
What? What doesn't make sense?
That he tried to hurt your baby. I've only thought about it.
Only thought about what?
No, you don't understand. It's not me, it's her.
Who? Helen! What the hell are you talking about?
Go away.
Helen! Helen, please, please. Please, I'm going crazy here. Helen, help me! Please let me in, I just need to talk to you. Helen!
When I was a little girl, maybe 8, my parents were trying to have another child. My mother, you see, all the babies after me were stillborn.
My wife and I, our first 3 children were stillborn.
So you've seen them?
Who?
The stillborn.
What do you mean, the stillborn?
I mean stillborn children. You've seen what they look like.
Yes. They're not how you would imagine them. They're not how you would want to remember. They're not the peaceful little versions of the living. Their faces are frozen in anguish. Disfigured and bruised, deformed.
He'd given up on my mother, my father. He was sure she was gonna kill this baby too. It was a girl. When she didn't breathe, my dad just stared straight ahead, never said a word. After a moment, he picked up the baby, placed it in a sack, picked up his shovel, and headed into the forest. My father and I weren't very close. He pretty much stayed clear of me. I was always watching him. Followed him into the forest that night to see where he was going to put my sister. He came to a clearing in the forest, dropped the bag, and began to dig. As he dug, all I could do was stare at that bag sitting on the ground, lifeless. And it happened. The bag moved. Not much. Enough to know that the baby inside was still alive. His hole was dug. He picked up the bag, tossed it in, began to shovel dirt into the hole. I was frozen with fear. My legs wouldn't move. I just sat there as he buried my sister. All I could do was watch. After he left, I just sat there and cried. I did nothing. Just sat and watched. That night after I went to bed was when I first heard the cries. I knew it was her. She was screaming at me.
She tried to hurt you?
Mostly just the crying. I don't know what's happening to your baby.
What did she say?
She can't help.
What's that?
It's a video monitor. Hope it still works.
So what are we gonna do?
Just have to watch until we can get out of here. I don't trust the audio monitor. This way we can see what he's doing. I'm gonna get some batteries. I thought I saw us.
What?
Never mind.
Well, you can't do that. Not after everything that's been happening. What?
I thought I saw something hurting Sam.
Who?
I don't know.
He's fine. Go back to bed.
Julie, what would you do if something...
If something goes wrong, believe me, you'll know.
Okay. I just want to make sure.
Frank, I can take care of him. Turkey, you can brown. Yeah. Hey, nobody's forgotten you. Mommy's just basting. Hey, Sleepy.
You're filthy.
We can eat as soon as the turkey browns.
What's going on?
We're celebrating.
Why?
Because we have power.
Oh, thank God. Honey, where's Sam?
Don't do that. That's not funny.
Oh my God, get him out! Get him out!
Julie? Julie? Julie?
Where did you go?
I've been looking for you. Why did you run away?
I heard something.
Julie, I need to know that you can do this. I need to know that you can protect him.
I can't.
Yes, you can, Julie.
I can't.
His life might depend on it.
Frank, would you listen to me? I can't. Wrong. I don't understand. I hurt my arm.
Did that hurt? Tell me what happened.
Can't remember.
I just pulled a 2-inch sliver from your arm. You're gonna tell me you don't know what happened?
I fell asleep. And then I woke up and I couldn't feel my arm. Maybe I was sleepwalking. What are you doing?
I'm just gonna put Sam in the nursery.
No, I can still help take care of him.
Fine. You need to get some rest.
No. No, Frank, please. Please don't take him away from me.
Get some sleep.
No, Frank, please. Please don't do this to me.
sister? What do you want? Don't hurt my baby, please. Julie, wake up.
It's all right. Thomas.
It's 5 a.m.
Why? What's happening?
I saw the ghost.
What? Where?
In the nursery.
When? Just now?
Video monitor. It's not a baby.
What?
I don't know why I keep hearing a baby crying.
Frank, listen to yourself. You're not making any sense.
It means Helen isn't telling the truth. Or maybe she is. Maybe it's a whole nother ghost. Maybe Helen has nothing to do with it. Either way, I have to find out. I have to talk to Helen. You're gonna have to watch Sam.
You can't just leave us here.
I have to.
Not when you think there's some kind of ghost in the other room.
I don't think it wants to hurt Sam. I think it's trying to do something else. I think it's trying to warn us.
Frank, I'm not staying here alone.
Okay. I'm gonna get him something warmer. It's okay. Just watch Sam. I'll be right back.
Okay, I can do it. Okay, just come back.
I'll be right back.
Up.
We gotta get out of here now.
No.
What do you mean, no?
It's too late.
We gotta take him to the hospital.
We can't. The roads are blocked.
I'll walk if I have to.
We failed him, Frank. We failed him from the very beginning. And every second this goes on, every second that we stand by and watch him suffer, we're failing him that much more. Let me hold him. I'm ready. Frank, please, I know it's time.
I don't think it's a very good idea.
I need to touch him, please. I'm ready to touch him.
No, you're not ready. You can hold him. As soon as we get out of here, you'll have plenty of time to hold him.
Give him to me.
I'm trying to help him. I'm trying to protect my family. Can't you see that, Julie? Julie? Thank you.
Please help! Helen! It wasn't your sister. Please just take Sam. Please take him.
No, Frank, you don't understand. You don't understand. This is her. This wind. This is her screaming and clawing at the world. Don't you know that?
No, it's not.
The moment I touch your baby is the moment she takes his life. Please, keep him away from me.
You were just 8 years old. Your imagination just played tricks on you. How would you know if... it's her.
Because she's done it before. I was trying to make things right. So I became a midwife. Everything was fine until I helped deliver my first baby, until I touched him. He died, Frank. They all died. Each one I touched was stillborn. She's cursed me. She won't let me redeem myself. She won't let me feel the joy of giving life. Only guilt and sorrow because I stole life.
But Sam's alive. And Julie's gonna die. You can help save a life. Please, please take him. Please. What are you doing? Yeah, you're okay.
Oh. Oh, Frank.
Yeah, baby.
Oh, Frank, you can't see it, can you?
What?
He's been dead for days, maybe longer.
No. It's a trick.
No.
You said she would try to do this.
No.
What did you do to my baby?
Where's your wife, Frank?
You stay away. Stay away from her.
All right.
soon as the roads are clear, we'll take him to the doctor, I promise. But until then, we have to do this together, okay?
Who are you? Helen's sister? What do you want?